So using Artist, we're going to set up our lower third and rig it for the template. So I set up a scene already here just to save a little bit of time. So I'm going to double click it to open it, and I'll just show you how I set it up here. First thing that we have here is a lower third bar. And I just used two rectangles here to create this lower third. So it's two rectangles. And beyond that, we also have this little noggin here, which I have a logo mapped to. And we're going to give the ability to swap out this logo. Now I have it mapped to a noggin to contain the size of the logo. So no matter which one we swap out, it should always fit in that little area. Beyond the lower third, we also have this little violator, or you may know it as something different. But we're going to keep this within this scene too. Now you may want to break out some of these things into their own scenes, all depending how you have your lower third set up. Since this lower third is not transition logic, we're not breaking everything out into different scenes. We're just going to keep everything within this scene so we can focus more on the functionality of the template as opposed to just design. So this violator here has two parts to it. It has a little backplate, which I have contained in this group, and it also has some text. And I basically have four lines of text here. One of them is blank. So we're going to use an OMO to actually switch these on and off. But beyond the violator, we also have one more option that we contained within the scene. It's called the upper left. And again, the upper left group here has four different containers in here. So as I switch through each one, we have a breaking news, we have a live, and then we have an on location button that we can switch to. So now what I'm going to do is actually rig this lower third so that we can actually create a template. One of the first things that I know that I need is a OMO function. So I want to be able to change these lines of text here. So I'm going to go into the built-ins and get the OMO first. I'm going to go into the tools folder and drag the OMO onto our topmost group so that when I click on my OMO here, as I click through each one of these numbers, you can see it now switches to whichever one we want. So not only do I want it on the violator text, but I also need it on the upper left. So I'm going to take the OMO and drag it to the upper left as well. I click on the OMO and go through each one of these numbers, it should change the upper left selection as well. From here, I'm going to start rigging it out with these control plugins. So if we're in the container plugins in the control folder, all of these things here are going to be used to give control to the producers. First thing I know that I want to give them control is the name. So I'm going to drag a control text down onto this group. I'm going to click on the control text to go into the editor, and I'm going to set the field identifier to 1, and the description is already set to name, and that's fine. Next one, I'm going to add another control text to the location text. So I'm click on the control text on here. This one is now field identifier 2. The description is fine. It's location. So I'm just going to leave all the default settings as it is. The third control plugin that we'll need is to swap out the logo. So within here on my noggin, I have a logo, and I'm going to use this control image to be able to swap this out. If I click on the control image function, and within the editor here, I'm going to change this to field identifier 3 since it's our third control function within this scene. So moving down to our next area here, the violator. First thing I know that I want to do is be able to turn this little chiclet or backplate on or off. So I'm going to use this control container to do that. I'm going to drag this control container onto the group. Click on the control container function, and I'm going to set the field identifier to 4 since this is our fourth control function within the scene. The only option that I want in here is the expose visibility. So I'm going to turn this to on. Now the next part, violator text. If I click on the OMO again, we can use this to change our different options here. So I'm going to drag this control OMO down onto this group. I click on the control OMO editor, and this is going to be field identifier number 5. Now, last one that we need here is another control OMO on the upper left. I'm going to click on the control OMO, and I'm going to make the field identifier number 6 in this one. Now, since we had everything stacked within a topmost group, when we added these control function plugins, it also added this control object at the topmost group automatically. So this just needs to be there so that Template Wizard can actually read this scene. Now, we also put a key channel on here on the topmost group. So if I hit the key here, everything should be keyed out as well. So what we're going to do is save this and then take this into Template Wizard. Now once in Template Wizard, what we can do is just come to File, and we're going to go to Wizard, and this is going to help us create the template. From here, we can navigate to our folder structure. We can find the scene that we just created. Here's my L3 scene. So I'm going to highlight this and drag it over to the right-hand column. What I can do is hit Next or Finish. I'm going to hit Go Ahead and hit Next. And what that does is actually lists all of our control plugins that we added to the scene. So here we can see that we have 6 of them. Everything looks good. I'm going to hit finish. And what it does is actually creates this template. Now this template is pretty much set and ready to go. It's a functioning template, and if we go try it right now, we could actually use this to send our graphic to air. So here, if I come into the template and go into run mode, we can just change a couple of things. I'll retype some text in here. I'll turn off our chiclet, and I'm just going to change these numbers here, and I hit play. Here you can see how it brought in the upper left, but we do have a problem because the chiclet is off. So let's turn that on, and we'll hit play again. There you can see it brings up the chiclet. It changed our text, so everything's looking good at this point. So what we can do now from here, we can either save this template, or we can go a step further by embellishing this template a little bit more for the producers. And that's the next step that we're going to cover.